Plato and Aristotle kicks off the basic queries on which all that has come up during the last 2000 years, including today's scenario, are dependent. We have built forward, we have gone forward, but Plato, by putting up questions on nature of imitation, inspiration, etc., gives the, ding dong bell, and Aristotle puts it on the proper aesthetic platform. Plato just raised the queries, but Plato was biased by his moral disposition. But Aristotle gives us the grand framework of logic and aesthetic queries to be properly taking place, the poetical, aesthetical query, and literature, how to, the yardsticks for judging literature, evaluating literature, was at all started off by Aristotle.
So, sir, according to your opinion, who initiated the tradition of Western aesthetic criticism?
Plato and Aristotle are joint sponsors. We must, give both of them credit. But Plato was more of a philosopher. His discourse was socio-philosophical, moral, and political discoursing. He wasn't actually giving his diktats on poetry per se, themselves. But Aristotle scooped out literature and put it on a pedestal and showed that literature justifies its existence and does await being discussed and judged by aesthetic terms, by applying aesthetic criteria. So I think Aristotle is the proper founder, initiator of this great heritage of literary criticism.
So could we say that the Plato observes poetry or art in general with the tool which is philosophical, and Aristotle's tool is rather based on art only,
based on judging art aesthetically and evaluating the critiquing, the criticism faculty is initiated by Aristotle in secular aesthetic terms.
And as far as the study of aesthetic is concerned, sir, both Plato and Aristotle are speaking on mimesis.
Right.
Could you explain the term mimesis?
Mimesis is a Greek word which means imitation. But imitation is open-ended. What kind of imitation? What for imitation? Like, for instance, Plato says imitation is bad because imitation deflects things from its original ideal archetypal thing, and its imitation is a copy, so a copy is not original, therefore a copy is untruth. Aristotle says no, the opposite of truth is untruth, but Plato says poets are liars because they don't bring up the ideal reality. Aristotle says lie is opposite of fact, meaning events and occurrences within the mundane sphere of existence, this mortality bound, time bound, temporal space. But truth is universal. Truth doesn't nick into our immediate perspective. So poets, because they imagine, because they imitate, they imitate reality through their insight, are not actually liable to lying, because they already say that I imagine. So they are not operating within the field of accountability or liability, like in law. They are not guilty of perjury. The poet says, I imagine, I fancy. So the fact-lie dichotomy doesn't come in. And the poets and Aristotle justifies imitation as representation factually, meaning the poet applies his intuition, he represents his perception of reality. So that way, imitation in art is justified very solidly, meaning he is not lying, he is recreating through his perception and intuition a shape of the outer reality, and he is adding his own insight into that, so he is not liable to committing untruths. Rather, he is helping truth, meaning the abiding essence of his feelings if they have got any abiding essence in them, will be of a lasting value.